So now we are back after a few hours of investigations and research and measuring around in the crowbar system. I came to, it was those two relays being activated all the time. So there's a system monitoring some voltages and the different of voltages in here. And this system was just always activating like ticky, ticky, ticky fast. And I came to those diodes, they were shorted. And the guy before me mounted 200 volts diodes instead of 600 volts diodes. So of course they're shorted. Two diodes in series. You should really, really be careful and look up the data sheet for voltage requirements and put in something that can do at least that if you don't have the right ones. And I find another one that they also replaced with a 200 volts diode. This one is not blown up yet, but of course I changed it to a 600 volts as specified. I even put in a 1.6 amp instead of 1 amp. So this is how you should do it. So now I feel actually lucky. Let's try and attach voltmeter to the input. Let's do this and see if there's a winner winner or a big loser loser, right? Ooh, no clickety clickety. So that was standby. I don't know what that means. But I got minus 0.2 volts, 12 watts of power. Let's... Ooh, scary. Oh, fuck me. I got scared. But I should actually know this was going to happen because this relay is the output shorting relay. And of course it is a humongously big relay. Oh, but I got a shock. That was actually fun. But let's try and do it again, okay? Okay, don't be scared. It's perfectly normal. Okay, I got... Did I connect something wrong here? 0 point something and it's counting the wrong way. Ah, damn it. It's this. Whoa! Current limiting is actually responding. So far, so good. Minus 0.8. Something is still not working. Have we got any kind of response on any of the dials? Nope. No response whatsoever. Nada, nada, nothing. So that is how it is. So this is the 10 volts. We should be able to do 100. Nope. 0.9 volts of output. Okay. I will get back and measure a little bit. I don't know if this is cheating or if it is, I don't know, something else. Well, this is what I do. I just use a thermal camera and take a picture of this area. And of course, there's a resistor that is way too hot here. And this is the drop resistor for this signal diode. See, I removed one of the pins from the board so I can prove the shorted signal. It is that easy with a thermal camera, and it's just always saving so much time. Debugging, screwing around with test points and looking up in test point table, and they don't even tell where's the reference and to this and that and where do you measure, and just go for a thermal camera. Easy, easy. All I need to do is figure out what is the specifications for CR48. Yeah, so it did bother me about the missing display frame, the meter frame. So I tried to measure this up as best as possible and figure out the plate thickness and the display and all that. I only got pictures from other videos and from magazines and from anything. that showed me how it looked. I didn't have any measurements, so I just tried my very best. So there are actually three screws for the display adjustments. So if you loosen all three, you can turn the display and move it and flex it a little bit. And this way you should be able to align the display to the frame and to get a perfect view, exactly what you want. Oh, I also changed the three LEDs here because there were a very, very big difference in their brightness. I haven't figured out what this LED does. I guess it says on, but mine just never lights up. And I really like the red one here when something is wrong, when there's an overload in current. So I like to keep this one red because that makes sense. I don't really like red indicators for on. That one should be green as well. So I'm going to repair this. Maybe it's just the LED. Maybe it's a wire, a resistor, or wherever this voltage is coming from. I didn't figure that out yet. Well, that is where I am at the moment. And here is the display frame design. It's looking really nice. I rounded the edges a little bit so it would be easier to print and to look real good. I suggest you put this edge towards your bed, and this way you can print it without support. Yes, I am 3D printing a new display frame. I'm rotating it like this to get the best possible quality, and I'm also printing it in 0.1 millimeter layer height, and this way it takes 38 minutes because I want this to look as nice as possible. If you look really, really careful, can you see the difference? This one is an LED. This one is not. That got me fooled. So what the heck? Those are LEDs as well, right? I just changed them. But look at that one. See what they did? There's a piece of metal sticking out here on the back. Wow, look at that. And then that was the two wires. And look at this. This thingy, there's a bulb in there. I don't know if that is possible to photo. Yeah, there is a bulb. So that rubber thingy made with this little piece of metal. And this is the on indicator. All I need to figure out is how many volts is this and what drives it. And because I really would like to have an LED there, because this, I don't want to have this problem again. Oh, did you see I cleaned it a little bit? It is nice and clean now. Well, oop, a little bit of dirt is... Okay, whatever. I almost cleaned it. All right, so I go and play with the bulb thing. Maybe this is explained in the manual somewhere. Instead of reading manuals and stuff, how about just measure the voltage? Okay, so it's 24 volts. But the logic here is a little bit missing. So the positive is the white one. Brilliant. That is funny. I just took a standard 3 millimeter red LED and stuck it up the little hole here and put my banana plugs here. of course, this is important to say this loud. While I'm doing this test, there is no mains connector connected, all right? Because this is the hot switch, all right? So be careful here. So with this, I get a really nice bright light. It's difficult to show on the camera. And then I measure the voltage drop is 1.8 volts and only 6 milliamps is needed for today's LEDs. And with this, I can calculate the series resistor from the 24 volts. That should be possible, right? So this is how I did it. The white one is the positive, and here is 3K6, little piece of red wire, and the positive part of the LED, fantastic. And the orange one is the negative side of the LED. So I'm ready to solder the LED, heat shrink this, and then glue it up there with a little drop of contact glue. So this is where we are today. We got the power LED and the green LEDs. We got 10 volts. And I only changed two diodes that were shorted. One that I didn't like, which were not shorted. And a shorted zener diode. And yeah, that's actually it. I didn't touch any trimmers or anything else because I need access to some more accurate equipment. And I also need a little bit more information about how to trim this and what the different trimmers they will do. So far, I think it's better not to touch anything as long as it is really looking good. So what I have done here is, this is 10, it should be 10, I think it is close enough to 10. This is where I left it yesterday. I just turned this on like 2 or 3 minutes ago, and it is the last two dials. This is the error that I'm compensating for. And again, I didn't trim anything. So I guess nobody touched the trimmers for 50 years. So I'm quite happy about this. And if I go to the one, this should be one, right? With the same settings. So this is a little bit low. So that was one. So that is 10 and then 100. So that means that, and if I go from 100 to 10, and back to 1, okay, so it's a little bit low in the last range. So, and if I touch the dial a little bit, nah. So I need to learn a little bit more about the adjustments before I touch anything. And I'm also very happy about the own designed, own 3D printed. This is done in PLA, and it is the files, they will be in the description, so you can get those for free. There is one thing that I don't like so much, and that is, you see those two powerful resistors down there? Well, the big power. Let's get some light. See, the fun thing is, one is really, really hot. Let's see how hot it is. 100. So the right one is 100, and the other one is nothing. And that is because the left one is shorted by the voltage settings. So in all the settings below 500 volts, the left one is shorted. And this is just how they designed this thing. So why is the other one 100? Ah, that is crazy. I really don't like something to be 100 degrees right up important capacitors. All the other resistors down here, see? No big deal. This is 36. Where are the other ones? So all the other resistors down here, see? Nothing. But it's the two power resistors down here. No big deal. 36. Yeah, but this is definitely going to be a problem with lifetime. So I was thinking about maybe putting those two in series under all circumstances. But I don't know what will be the side effect of that.